Hey, Dean Yeager.
It's going to be a little different today. We want to start talking about directors. We have a lot of favorite directors, but some of them are going to be very hard to do a top four. I mean, the actors are hard enough, but it's fun and it keeps it within a certain time frame.
Right.
But with directors, we thought, what the heck? Let's just forget about the time limit. Let's just go for it. And we're going to start, we're going to use our source, IMDb, and we're going to start a director, start his first director film all the way up to his last. And if we've seen it, we're going to talk about it and we're going to give it a grade. If we haven't seen it, you know, we may give it a brief description, say if we're going to watch it or not, or, you know, just keep going. So the first one today is
Walter Hill.
Walter Hill. I am pretty familiar with Walter Hill. I know there's a lot that I don't like, but that's why we're doing it.
He's one of my favorite directors.
You can see where we're going with this. It's one of his favorites.
It's awesome.
Well, let's do it.
Okay. All right. He started off before that, actually writing and producing films. But the first film he directed was in 1975. It was called Hard Times with Charles Bronson.
I never saw it.
Well, let me start off by saying that I own most, I've seen, I'd say 99%, and I own about 90% of all of Walter Hill's films he's ever done.
That's great. Have you seen it?
Yes, I've seen it, I own it, and it's great. James Coburn is in it. Basically what it boils down to is Charles Bronson plays a street fighter. For money, basically.
Okay.
And I think the shot, of course, they made it in 75, but I believe it takes place in the 50s. And Coburn plays his promoter.
Interesting. I would have to...
You know, it's a good directorial debut from Hill. And Bronson, you know...
Bronson is Bronson.
Yeah.
It's definitely worth a look.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool.
So that was his first one. The second one was in 78, was The Driver with Ryan O'Neal.
The Driver. I did like The Driver. I did. I liked it.
Yeah.
I've only seen it once. Sorry, Joe. But no, I enjoyed it. I remember when you said you got it, we're going to watch it. It's not one of my favorites, but it was definitely entertaining.
Yeah.
And the way it was shot, you know, it's shot like Walter Hill.
Yeah. Ryan O'Neal plays a getaway driver, you know.
That was before it was diluted with all these getaway driver movies.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah, and Bruce Dern plays the cop trying to catch him.
I like Bruce.
Always a couple steps behind. But, yeah, so that was the second film. Third film was what brought, I guess, as a director anyway, brought Hill to the mainstream audience, The Warriors.
That's what I'm talking about. Warriors is one of my favorite films. I love the film. You know, we could talk all day about this, but I know we got a bunch to get through, so keep going.
Yeah, love Warriors, but I don't think I actually saw it all the way through until, you showed it to me the first time I watched it all the way through, I believe. I can't remember exactly, but yeah, I love it. I think it's great. James Remar's in it.
Yeah.
And David Patrick Kelly.
Walter Hill staple.
Yes, yes he is. And you'll see more of that.
I'm sure.
So in 1980, he came along and he did The Long Riders, Western.
We saw that, right? You had me see it?
Yes. The Western, based on the real life gangs that were comprised of brothers, basically.
Yeah, and they used actual brothers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dennis Quaid, Randy Quaid.
Keith Carradine.
Yeah.
Robert Carradine. David Carradine, for goodness sakes. And the Guest brothers, Christopher Guest and his brother. And so that was a good Western, I thought.
But yeah, he's on a roll here.
Yeah.
I'm afraid we're going to come down here in a minute.
So we come along in 1981. And
so
he
it's
does,
not 82. So I know it comes in 82.
He does Southern Comfort.
Oh, man, that was... If we're rating this, I give it 4 out of 10. It just didn't make sense. It just didn't. And like I said, we want to keep this brief because there's a lot to get through. It just didn't make a lot of sense. I mean, basic overview, it's a group of Army. I don't remember if they're Army or Navy SEALs. It seems like they're starting out like they're in Cambodia or something. But no, they're in the backwoods of New Orleans, which makes, why would you be back there at all? And it never really explains why they're back there, if I don't remember right.
Well, they're doing like military maneuvers and exercise, stuff like
but
that.
But why would you pick New Orleans? I just don't get it. And then, of course, you run, obviously it wouldn't have been a movie if they didn't run into some backwoods crazy people. But that's the gist of it. I know what you're going to say. You loved it. So just get it out.
Brian James plays the one Arcadian.
Your boy's on water out here.
You got Powers Booth. You got David, I'm sorry, Keith
Powers
Carradine.
Booth was the only thing that was worth it, but he didn't never really get a chance to shine, in my opinion. But like I said, we talk about these all day.
After that.
Locked your phone up.
1982, 48 hours.
48 hours. Probably my favorite Walter Hill director film, one of my favorite Eddie Murphy films, Nick Nolte films. I loved 48 Hours when it came out. Just loved it. And again, Warriors, 48 Hours, I grew up watching that. I mean, I was watching that 8, 9 years old with my parents. They loved the film, and I loved it immediately when I watched it. You know, can't say enough about that.
Walter Hill hit another success on that one. After that, he tried something different. He tried... A rock and roll...
Can we just move? Just keep going. Keep going.
Rock and roll fable, pseudo quasi action.
Don't say it.
Streets of Fire. Michael Pear, Diane Lane, and Willem Dafoe.
You could have had Steven Spielberg direct that and it wouldn't have saved that film.
Rick Moranis was in it.
Sorry, Rick Moranis, man. No wonder you don't do anything anymore. No, Streets of Fire is rough. Rough. And I haven't even seen it all the way through, and I don't plan on it either.
You know, I think it was misunderstood. I enjoy the film. I've got the soundtrack to it. I really think it got a bad rap. So anyway,
to disagree on that.
So he decided... Okay, well, let's try something. Maybe the studio decided for him at that point. Let's try something different, Walter. And he went ahead and did Brewster's Millions.
I really want to see that. John Candy, Richard Pryor. I've seen a little trailer, if that's a legit trailer or not. I really want to see that. That looks actually pretty entertaining. John Candy, you can't go wrong with John Candy.
Yeah, it was pretty good. I don't think it was... I think it was after Warriors 48 Hours. He didn't really have hits for a while.
Yeah, well, and I know we're gonna really get off the tracks here soon. So,
The thing, just as an aside, he did write the story for Aliens, and he produced all the Aliens films from the first one all the way through. I think it was Resurrection, even Prometheus. So he's always been on board with them.
Great, you should have directed them.
But anyway, okay, so moving along, Crossroads.
I have no idea what Crossroads is, never heard of it, never seen it.
I saw it once.
Saw it once?
Yeah.
There it is.
You know, I don't own it. It's a pretty good movie. Actually, Ralph Macchio, his presence in it wasn't enough, I think, to put it.
Probably not. Wait a minute, isn't that about he's like a musician or something?
It's... Almost like it's about blues, and it's almost like
I think I saw a scene where he has like a guitar duel.
If you know the song, and everyone does, "The Devil Went Down to Georgia."
Yeah,
it's almost like a film adaptation of that to some degree.
Yeah,
only with blues instead of So anyway, so moving along, we've got Extreme Prejudice in 87. Now that's a heck of a film.
That's Nick Nolte, right?
Yes, and Powers Booth.
I've seen it once. It was okay. It was okay.
It's Michael a lot better Anderson. Than
I think what you're going to come up with next. But it was okay. I only seen it once. I don't have a lot of memories of it. But it was okay. It was a lot better than a lot of stuff he's made me watch before. But yeah, it was all right.
Well, it was sort of, even Hill said it was sort of an homage to the old spaghetti westerns.
I didn't feel that. I remember that. I did not get that feeling.
But, you know, I love that film. And again, that's part of my collection, too.
Of course it is.
So, Extreme Prejudice.
No.
Oh, one of my favorites. Red Heat.
I forgot he directed Red Heat. Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, Schwarzenegger, Jim Belushi's a cop in Chicago. Schwarzenegger is a
Russian.
He's
a Russian. It wouldn't have been half bad if he didn't try to play a Russian. I mean, he's still got the Austrian accent, trying to do a Russian accent. It's just bad. And Jim Belushi, I like some of his comedy stuff. That was not one of his best.
You think so? Or you don't think so?
I know so.
I mean, honestly, I think it's a great film. I grew up watching that.
The only thing great is Edo Ross playing a Russian.
Oh, man.
They thought he was Russian after that. He played it so well.
Yeah. If you wanted a scumbag in the 80s and the early 90s, you got Edo Ross.
Yeah. But it didn't save the film.
All
right. Agree to disagree.
After that, he did Johnny Handsome.
I don't think I ever saw Johnny Handsome. Who's in that?
Real quick lowdown, Mickey Rourke.
Oh, yeah. I know where you're going now.
Yeah, Mickey Rourke. He's part of a crew with Lance Henriksen and Ellen Barkin. And they screw him over one of their last heists. And they shoot him. And it basically, I think he goes through some glass plating or something.
He's basically played by one actor, and then he's a different actor later.
Right. And he's supposed to get, cosmetic surgery, comes back for revenge against his old crew. It's very simple.
Very simple, but very...
Yeah.
Very weak. All right.
That's another
one. I have not seen it all the way through, but once you told me Mickey Rourke, I wasn't... You can just go. You don't have to say it. I see it from here.
Another 48 hours.
Stop it. No. Terrible. It was nowhere near as good as the first one.
I liked Another 48 Hours.
You just liked it because Brian James got a bigger part in it. That's got to be the Iceman.
No, he was supposed to even have a bigger part than that.
It wouldn't have saved it.
It's
supposed to be like 5 years later. But you can tell that Nick Nolte's put on like 30 pounds. Eddie Murphy has definitely put on some weight. It just doesn't, I don't know. I don't know. I don't like it. I didn't like it.
Ed O'Ross was in that one too.
Yeah. Again, it didn't help. I'm telling you, man, this is where we're going off the rails because I know he did a lot of crap in the 90s.
Anyway, so after that, excuse me, after that he does... Trespass in 92.
Trespass, I only saw it once, but I have to admit it was decent. You got the late great Bill Paxton in it. Ice-T's in it.
Ice-T and Ice Cube, man.
Oh, man.
You killed Lucky, man. I want my brother back, man. Remember?
Yeah, I do remember.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Another pretty simple concept. You got two firemen. Bill Paxton and what's his name?
William Sadler.
Bad guy in Die Hard 2. that was good.
Yeah.
But evidently they get some quote unquote a treasure map where they're supposed to be. Is it treasure or just money?
No, it's treasure.
It's treasure.
Yeah.
Well, they get there. Everything's going great. Well, then Ice-T and Ice Cube show up with the crew.
Yeah.
And the hits the fan. But I mean, it was all right. It was all right.
Yeah, dude, it was awesome. I love that film.
It was okay.
I remember, in fact, I'm pretty sure I saw that one in the theater.
I'm sure you did.
So after that, he does Geronimo, an American Legend. Of course, obviously, it's a biopic based on the Native American Geronimo warrior.
Never saw it. Never heard of it.
Excellent film. Gene Hackman's in it. Very
Hackman's in it. I got to check it out. And I'm not saying that to be a joke. I like Gene Hackman.
That's an excellent film. Matt Damon, probably 20 years old, maybe.
Wow.
In it. Jason Patrick. Really is a good film. Wes Studi plays, Geronimo. And he's always dances with wolves and everything. He's always been a great character actor.
Gotcha.
Love it. And it's not one of his better known films, though. So from there, he goes on to do another Western. I'd say it's a biopic, but it's really probably more what would you say, creative license than anything, Wild Bill by Wild Bill Hickok, with Jeff Bridges in the title role.
I think I remember that. Who else is in it?
You had a few others in there. Bruce Dern makes an appearance. You had James Gammon. You had John Hurt. Ellen Barkin, I think, shows up again as Calamity Jane.
And William Dafoe in it?
No.
Okay, well, then I'm thinking another movie. Then, no, I don't think I've seen it.
Wild Bill's good. I mean, if for no other reason than for Jeff Bridges.
Okay.
You know. We should do one on him, you know.
Yeah,
for Jeff Bridges. So, okay, so Wild Bill. Then we go in, then...
This is where we really get off the railroad tracks here.
So he decides at that point he wants to do, you know, a gangster film set, you know, Prohibition.
Oh, no.
Last Man Standing, which is essentially another retelling of the Yojimbo story.
It was a modern Fistful of Dollars.
Yeah, it was.
That's basically what it was. It was the same thing. And I say modern. It was based in the 1920s. So you take the Fistful of Dollars, which was obviously a Western film, 1800s, and you put it in the 1920s. That's the gist of it. The only great thing was Walken was the villain.
Yeah, you had Walken, David Patrick Kelly.
Bruce Willis is
Kelly shows up again. Yeah, Bruce Willis. And Patrick Kilpatrick is in it.
Great.
You know, Patrick Kilpatrick from Scanner's Cop series?
No, I wouldn't know. Next.
Okay, so a few years pass by, and he does a forgettable sci-fi film, which apparently was cut to shreds by the studio so much that he decided he wanted his name taken off, given a ghost credit on
it. Oh, this is great.
Supernova.
Never saw it. Don't plan on seeing it either.
Yeah, James Spader. I've seen the majority of it.
I knew you did.
You bet. It's pretty rough.
If he's saying it's rough, it is unbearable.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
All right.
And there's a reason why Hill had his name taken off. So after that, he does Undisputed.
Isn't that one with Wesley Snipes and
Ving Rhames in the prison?
Yeah. I saw the trailer. I seen the cover of the DVD box. Don't plan on watching it. Just not.
It was all right. It wasn't that bad. Now he redeems himself. A few years later with Broken Trail, a two-part TV Western miniseries.
Never saw it.
That was always Walter Hill's bread and butter. He always loved the Westerns. And to do Western, it was his favorite genre. You had Robert Duvall and Thomas Hayden Church. Just a really great story.
Might have to check it out.
Yeah.
I like Thomas Hayden Church and Robert Duvall.
So after that, a few more years pass. He goes into semi-retirement.
And then he does...
Bullet to the Head.
Bullet to the Head. Not one of Stallone's greatest, but I liked it. Jason Momoa is in it. It's the bad guy. It was decent.
Man, it's okay. It's a far cry from where he was in the 70s and 80s.
It's a lot better than Streets of Fire. A lot better. A lot better. It was good. I liked it. Now, I've only seen it once.
Well, the last film he did in his IMDb directing credit is one that I haven't seen.
I haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's called The Assignment.
I seen it!
No, yeah, Michelle kidding. Rodriguez goes from a woman to a man or something, or a man to a woman.
No, I've never seen it. I don't want to see it.
Yeah, Sigourney Weaver is like some mad, crazy scientist comes after her.
It sounds like, what is that, The Tusk or whatever that Kevin James did, where the guy turns Jason Long into a walrus.
Oh, gosh, yeah, I don't want to see that.
But is that it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. You know, there's talk, and now Hill was just about 80 years old.
Wow.
He's still producing films.
Out of all of that, what would be your favorite?
That's a tough call.
Just off the top of your head.
I'd say probably 48 Hours, but I'd have to give it some thought.
Mine is The Warriors.
The Warriors? Yeah, okay.
I love The Warriors, but...
Because I did like Extreme Prejudice a lot.
Yeah, I know. But, yeah, that was different, but that was fun. Is that it?
Yeah, I hope that he keeps on doing more films. I hope that he
comes. I think he needs to retire. Not to, I just think it's time. He's 80 years old. Just let him enjoy the rest of his life.
Right, but, you know, Clint Eastwood keeps doing it.
That's Clint Eastwood. He's a whole other animal, man. Yeah, that guy will never stop. But anyway, give us some ideas. What did you like any of these Walter Hill's films that we mentioned? And
Andy, have you ever thought maybe the possibility of a 48 Hours 3?
Probably not. Is there a director out there you want us to do like this? We've got a few others in mind because we feel like this is a little more easier with the director. We can talk about some of the bad ones they did and obviously the good ones. So until next time, see you out there.
Bye.